Subject of Atomic Physics. Lecture number 7. SEM 1 Electron Atoms. Lecture plan. First, development of the Schrödinger equation, separation of the time-independent equation. Second, solution of the equations. Third, eigenvalues, quantum numbers and degeneracy, eigen functions. Fourth, probability densities. The fact that the one electron atom contains two particles causes no difficulty at all if use is made of the reduced mass technique. This technique models the actual atom by an atom in which the nucleus is infinitely massive and the electron has a reduced mass mu, given by next formula, where m is the true mass of the electron and m bigger is the true mass of the nucleus. The reduced mass electron moves about the infinitely massive nucleus with the same electron nucleus separation as in the actual atom. Since the infinitely massive nucleus must be completely stationary, it is necessary to treat only the motion of the reduced mass electron in the model atom. And the problem is therefore simplified from one involving a pair of moving particles to one involving only a single moving particle. In classical mechanics, the motion of the reduced mass electron about the stationary nucleus in the model atom exactly duplicates the motion of the electron relative to the nucleus in the actual atom. Furthermore, the total energy of the model atom, which is just the total energy of its reduced mass electron, equals the total energy of the actual atom in the frame of the reference in which its center of mass is at rest. Figure 6.1 indicates the behavior of the electron and the nucleus in the actual atom and in the model atom. In both cases, the center of mass of the atom is at rest. Development of the Schrödinger equation. We consider therefore an electron of reduced mass which is moving under the influence of the Coulomb potential. Next formula. Where x, y, z are the rectangular coordinates of the electron of charge minus e relative to the nucleus, which is fixed at the origin. The square root in the denominator is just the electron nucleus separation distance r. The nucleus charge is plus z multiplied e, z equals 1 for the neutral hydrogen, z equals 2 for the singly ionized helium, etc. As a first step, we must develop the Schrödinger equation for this three-dimensional system. We do this by using the next procedure. We first write the classical expression for the total energy E of the system. Formula 6.3. The quantities P sub X, P sub Y, and P sub Z are the X, Y, Z components of the linear momentum of the electron. Thus, the first term on the left is the kinetic energy of the system, while the second term is the potential energy. Now we replace the dynamical quantities P sub X, P sub Y, P sub Z, and E by their associated differential operators using an obvious three-dimensional extension of the scheme in 5.32. This gives in the operator equation. Formula 6.4. Operating with each term on the wave function, psi equals psi function from x, y, z, t, we obtain the Schrödinger equation for the system. Formula 6.6. It is often convenient to write this as next form, formula 6.7, where they use the symbol. Formula 6.8, which is called a Laplacian operator, or del squared is rectangular coordinates. Many of the properties of the three-dimensional Schrödinger equation and of the wave functions, which are its solutions, can be obtained by obvious extensions of the properties developed in the preceding lectures. For instance, it is easy to show by the technique of the separation of variables that since the potential function V, function x, y, z, does not depend on the time, there are solutions to the Schrödinger equations which have the form, next form, formula 6.9, where the eigenfunction psi x, y, z is a solution to the time-independent Schrödinger equation. Next formula, formula 6.10. Note that the three dimensions of the equation is a partial differential equation because it contains three independent variables, the space coordinates x, y, z. Separation of the time-independent equation. The time-independent Schrödinger equation for the Coulomb potential can be solved by making repeated applications of the technique of separation of variables to split the partial differential equations into a set of three ordinary differential equations, each involving only one coordinate, and then using standard procedure to solve these equations. However, separation of the variables cannot be carried out when rectangular coordinates are employed because the Coulomb potential, the potential energy as a function, the function from x, y, z of all three of these coordinates. Separation of variables is not work on the rectangular coordinates because the potential itself cannot be split into terms each is of which involves only on the such coordinate. The difficulty is removed by changing the spherical polar coordinates. There are the coordinates r, theta, phi, illustrated figure 6.2. The length of the straight of the connecting of the electron with the origin, the nucleus, is r, and theta and phi are the polar and azimuthal angles specifying the orientation of that line. Now, the distance between the electron and the nucleus is just r. So, in spherical polar coordinates, the Coulomb potential can be expressed as a function of single coordinate r as follows. Next formula. Formula 6.11. Because of this great simplification in the form of the potential, it then becomes possible to carry out the separation of variables on the time-independent Schrödinger equation. The split derivatives of the time-independent Schrödinger equation also change form when the coordinates are changed from rectangular to spherical. Straightforward, but tedious application of the rules of differential calculus shows that the time-independent Schrödinger equation can be written as formula 6.12, where formula 6.13 is a Laplacian operator in the spherical polar coordinates r, theta, phi. A comparison of this of the forms of the Laplacian operator in rectangular and spherical polar coordinates, formulas 6.8 and 6.13, shows that we have simplified the expression of the potential energy function at the expense of considerably complicating the expression of the Laplacian operator in the time-independent Schrödinger equation that must be solved. The spherical coordinates r, theta, phi at the point P and its rectangular coordinates x, y, z. Nevertheless, the change of the coordinates is worthwhile because it will allow us to find solutions to the time-independent Schrödinger equation of the form. Formula 6.14. That we shall show that there are solutions psi function of r theta phi to 6.12 formula that split into product of three functions, r functions of r, theta big theta function theta, and psi, each of which depends on the only one of the coordinates. The advantage is in the fact that these three functions can be found by solving ordinary differential equations. We show this by substituting the product from psi function of r theta and phi equals r function r multiplied theta function theta multiplied phi multiplied function phi into the time-independent Schrödinger equation obtained by evaluating the Laplacian operator in 6.12 from 6.13. This will equals next formula. Carrying out the partial differentials, we have next formula. In this equation, we have written the partial derivative, partial dr over dr as the total derivative dr over dr, since the two are equivalent because r is a function of r alone. The same comment applies to the other derivatives. If we now multiply through by minus 2 multiplied mu multiplied r square multiplied sine theta square divided r multiplied theta multiplied phi multiplied h bar square and transpose, we obtain next formula. As the left side of this equation does not depend on the r and or theta, whereas the right side does not depend on the phi. The common value cannot depend on any of these variables. The common value must therefore be a constant, which we shall find it convenient to designate as minus m sub l square, thus obtain two equations by setting each side equal to this constant. Formula 6.15. And another form, formula. By transporting, we can rewrite the second equation as next formula, as next form. Since we have here an equation whose left side does not depend on the one of the variables and whose right side does not depend on the other, we conclude again that both sides must equal a constant. It is convenient to design it the constant as L multiplied L plus 1. Thus we obtain by setting each side equal to L multiplied L plus 1 two more equations. 6.16 and 6.17. We see that the assumed product form of the solution psi function from r theta phi is valid because it is vox. We also see that the problem has been reduced to that of solving the ordinary differential equations 6.15, 6.16 and 6.17 for psi function from psi from phi, theta function from theta and r function from r. In solving these equations, we shall find that the equation of phi function of phi has acceptable solutions only for certain values of m sub l. Using these values of m sub l in the equation for theta functions of theta, it turns out that this equation has acceptable solutions only for certain values of l. With these values of l in the equations for r function, this equation is found to have acceptable solutions only for certain values of the total energy E. That is, the energy of the atom is quantized. Solution of the equations. Consider 6.15 for phi function of phi. By differentiation, the substitution, the student may easily verify that it has a particular solution function phi function equals e I multiplied m sub l multiplied phi power. Here we must for the first time explicitly consider the requirements that the eigenfunction be single value. This demands that the function phi be single valued, and the demand must be considered explicitly because the azimuthal angles ψ equals 0 and ψ equals 2 multiplied p are actually the same angle. Thus, we must require that the ψ function phi has the same value of at phi equals 0 as it does at phi equals 2 multiplied phi, that is phi equals phi function. Evaluating the exponential in the particular solution phi function, we obtain e 2 I multiplied m sub l multiplied 0 equals e 2 I multiplied m sub l multiplied 2 multiplied p, or 1 equals cosine m sub l multiplied 2 multiplied p plus I multiplied sine ml m sub l multiplied 2 multiplied p. The requirement is satisfied only if the absolute value of m sub l has one of the values ml absolutely l equals 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Formula 6.18. In other words, m sub l can be only a positive or negative integer. Thus, the set of the functions which are acceptable solutions of 6.15 are phi function, formula 6.19, where m sub l has one of the integral values specified by 6.18. The quantum number m sub l is used as a subscript to identify the specific form of an acceptable solution. In solving 6.16 for the functions theta function, the procedure is similar to that used to obtain analytical solutions of the time-independent Schrödinger equation for the simple harmonic oscillator potential. Here, we shall only quote the results. It is found that the solutions to 6.16, which are acceptable, remain finite, are obtained only the constant L is equal to one of the integers. L equals absolutely m sub l, or m absolutely m sub l plus 1, etc. Formula 6.20. The acceptable solutions can be written, formula 6.21, the f function from cosine theta are polynomials in cosine theta which have forms that depend on the value of the quantum number l and on the absolute value of the quantum number m sub l. Thus, it's necessary to use both of these quantum numbers to identify the function's theta function that are acceptable solutions to the equation. The procedure used in the solution of 6.17 for the function R function, which is also similar to that used for the simple harmonic oscillator potential, is also carried out. It is found that there are bound state solutions which are acceptable remain finite only if the constant E, the total energy, has one of the values En, where E sub n equals minus mu multiplied z to power multiplied E 4 power divided 4 multiplied p multiplied epsilon sub 0 square multiplied 2 multiplied h bar square multiplied n square. Formula 6.22. In this expression, the quantum number n is one of the integers. N equals l plus 1, l plus 2, l plus 3, etc. Formula 6.23. The acceptable solutions are most conveniently written as next form. Formula 6.24, where the parameter a sub 0 is equal almost 6.25. This is g function. Other polynomials in z multiplied r divided r sub 0 with different forms for the different values of n and l. Thus, both of these quantum numbers are required to identify the different functions r that are acceptable solutions to the equation. But the allowed values E sub n or the total energy carry only the quantum number n. As a label signs, they depend only on the value of the quantum number. Eigenvalues, quantum numbers, and degeneracy. One of the important results of the Schrödinger theory of the one electron atom is the prediction of 6.22 for the allowed values of total energy of the bound system of the atom. Comparing this prediction for the eigenvalues E sub 1 with the prediction of the Bohr model, we find that identical allowed energies are predicted by these treatments. Both predictions are in the excellent agreement with experiment. Schrödinger's derivation of 6.22 provided the first convincing verification of his theory of quantum mechanics. Figure 6.3 illustrates the Coulomb potential with V function of R for the one electron atom and its eigenvalues E sub 1. What is the relation between the Coulomb potential and its eigenvalues and the potential studied in lecture 5 and the eigenvalues? One obvious difference is that the quantum mechanical calculations leading to the eigenvalues of the Coulomb potential are appreciably more complicated. But the Coulomb potential is the description of a real three-dimensional system. The potentials previously treated up approximate descriptions of idealized one-dimensional systems, which are designed to simplify the calculations. Part of the complication for the Coulomb potential is also due to its spherical symmetry, which forces to use the spherical polar coordinates instead of rectangular coordinates. The similarities are much more fundamental than the differences. For the Coulomb potential, as for any other bending potential, we allow total energies of a particle bound to the potential are discretely quantized. Figure 6.4 makes a comparison between the allowed energy for the Coulomb potential and for the several one-dimensional bending potentials. In this figure, the Coulomb potential is represented on a crosscut along a diameter through the one electron atom. Note that all the bending potentials have a zero-point energy. That is, all cases, the lowest allowed value of total energy lies above the minimum value of the potential energy. Associated with its zero-point energy, the one electron atom has a zero-point motion, like other systems described by bending potentials. In the following sections, we shall see that this phenomenon can give us a basic explanation of the stability of the ground state of the atom. Figure 6.4, a comparison between the allowed energy of general bending potentials. Also, the eigenvalues of the one electron atom depend on only the quantum number n. The eigenfunctions depend on all three quantum numbers n, l, and m sub l, since they are products of the three functions, r functions, phi functions, and phi m sub l phi functions. The fact that three quantum numbers arise is a consequence of the fact that the time-independent Schrödinger equation contains three independent variables, one for each space coordinate. Gathering together to the conditions with the quantum numbers satisfying, we have three numbers, almost 6.26. These conditions are more conveniently expressed as next form, almost 6.27. Because of its role in specifying the total energy of the atom, n is sometimes called the principal quantum number. Because the azimuthal or orbital angular momentum of the atom depends on L, as we shall soon see, L is sometimes called the azimuthal quantum number. We shall also see that if the atom is an external magnetic field, there is a dependence of its energy on M sub L. Consequently, M sub L is sometimes called by magnetic quantum number. The conditions of 6.27 make it apparent that for a given value of n, there are generally several different possible values of L and M sub L. Since the form of the Eigen functions depends on all three quantum numbers, it is apparent that there will be situations in which two or more completely different Eigen functions corresponding to exactly the same eigenvalue E. As the Eigen functions describe the behavior of the atom, we see that there is states with completely different behavior that nevertheless have a sum total energy. In physics, the word used to characterize the phenomenon of its degeneracy and Eigen functions corresponding to the same eigenvalue are said to be generated. Degeneracy also occurs in classical mechanics and is related to old quantum theory. In the discussion of elliptical orbits of the Bohr-Sommerfeld atom, we indicate the total energy of the atom is independent of the semi-minor axis of the ellipse. Thus, the atom has states with very different behavior, that is, with the electron traveling in very different orbits, which nevertheless have the same total energy. Exactly the same phenomenon occurs in planetary motion. This classical degeneracy is comparable to the L-degeneracy that arises in the quantum mechanical one-electron atom. The energy of Bohr-Sommerfeld atom or a planetary system is also independent of the orientation in space of the plane of the orbit. This is comparable to the M sub L degeneracy of the quantum mechanical atom. In either classical or quantum mechanics, degeneracy is a result of certain properties of the potential energy function that describes the system. In the quantum mechanical one electron atom, the degeneracy with respect to M sub L arises because the potential depends only on the coordinate r. So the potential is spherically symmetrical and the total energy of the atom is independent of its orientation in space. The L degeneracy is a consequence of the particular from the r dependence of the Coulomb potential. If an external magnetic field is applied to the atom, then its total energy will depend on its orientation in space because of interaction between currents in the atom and the applied field. We shall study this later, and we shall find that the orientation in space is determined by the quantum number M sub L. Thus, in an external magnetic field, the degeneracy with respect to M sub L is removed and the atom has different energy levels for different M sub L values. If the external magnetic field is gradually reduced in intensity, the dependence of the total energy of the atom on M sub L is reduced in proportion. When the field is reduced to zero, the energy levels that correspond to different values of the M sub L degenerate into a single energy level, and the corresponding Eigen functions become generated. Many properties of alkali atoms can be discussed in terms of the motion of the single valence electron in a potential with a spherical symmetrical, but which does not have the 1 divided r behavior on the Coulomb potential. The energy of this electron does not depend on L. Thus, the degeneracy with respect to L is removed if the form of the r dependence of the potential is changed. From 6.27, it is easy to see how many generated Eigen functions, therefore, for an isolated one electron atom which correspond to the particular Eigen value E. The possible values of the quantum numbers for n equals 1, 2, and 3 are shown in table 6.1. Table 6.1, possible values of L and M sub L for n equals 1, 2, 3. Inspection on this table makes it apparent that, first, for each value of n, there are n possible values of L. Second, for each value of L, there are 2 multiplied 3 plus 1 possible values m sub L. For each value of n, there are a total of n square generated eigenfunctions. So, next slide, literature. And next, questions of the consolidated knowledge. First question. It was important equations of classical physics. Does not the Laplacian operator enter? Second question. Why do three quantum numbers arise to the treatment of the spinless one electron atom? Third question. Just what is the degeneracy? Fourth, what is the relation between the size of the Bohr atom and the size of the Schrödinger atom? Fifth, why does a uniform electric or magnetic field define only one unique direction in space? Thank you for your attention.